Today, let's start looking at the LS command in kernel Linux, but majorly in Linux systems. As for me, I'm using Linux, so let me open my terminal. Control Shift, let me zoom in now. Okay, so LS just means list storage. That's it. So when you ls, the first thing it comes just shows you all the directories and files you are in on the current working directory. So let's start with the first one, which is if you want to list all the hidden files, you just ls and an a. Okay, it shows you all the hidden files, and most of the hidden files always start with a dot. Dot and then followed by the name, so like dot config, dot cache, like dot face icon, like that, dot accession, blah blah. So let's go to the next command. Let's clear this. Just press Ctrl and L. If you want to see the long list, ls switch L. This it will show you all the long list. So with this we have all the column, we have various columns here. The first column, which starts with D, DI and end with an X, this shows the permission, like read, execute. That what it just shows, like for this just read and write, read. This for this MKV file we have here. For the next one, it shows the number of block memories it has taken, like this the desktop has taken 4, documents has taken 3, downloads has taken 3, and the MKV file has taken 1, this has taken 2, 9, like that. This is the first, second, this is the third one. The third, it shows the owner or the user who created it. This one shows the group it is in. This column here, this one shows the number of spaces has taken, and it's usually shown in bytes. This shows the date, the timestamp of which was created and last. Which was created and the timestamp and to when it was modified. This shows the actual name of the file or the directory, the last column. So let's proceed to our next command, which is ls switch longlist h. This for the human readable. It just shows a more human readable format for you. Yeah, that's all it shows. As you can see here, the files are just it's just basically the same as Ontopia, but more readable compared to how it was with the L command. Let's go to the next command, which is lh switch r. When you switch r, you just reverse the output of how it's supposed to be done, like when you do an ls. You see it start with the desktop, but if you switch R, it will start with the videos, which will appear last when you just use the list storage command. So let's go to the next one, which is ls switch capital R. So what this command does, you see the file and the content of the directories in the path, in the present path. So like in videos you have this templates, you have nothing, the dot public. We have code, blah blah. This is my VS code, which is, I saved it in the public. So it just shows you the contents of all the directories and files you have. That's what it majorly does. let's shorten the command, like let's pipe it to head only. Desktop, yeah. So with this, it has just broken, like for desktop, it has broken all the files and directories inside the desktop documents. So let's remove the pipe. Let's go to where it started. Like when you come to programs, you have the edX UI, source, node noodles. It shows all the files that are in there. So you go to program edX, like that. Let's clear the terminal. Just press Ctrl L. It will clear it for you instead of typing clear. I find Ctrl L much easier for me to use. So let's go to the next command, which is ls switch lt. What this shows, it just shows the last modified file, which is the last modified file we have is videos, and we modified that on July 27th and 107 p.m. Yeah, that's all. Yeah, that's the last time we modified it. So the next one will modify this. The one that we modified last was this. Was this file on music, public, in that order. Even you can just see with the dates, the timestamp. This one is 27, this one 26, 26, 26, 25, in that given order. So let's go to our next command, which is ls switch long capital S. This will show you the largest file, which is like this MKV file that which is a video. But that's the largest file we have. It will be shown at the top, and the list, this file with the smallest size will be shown at the bottom, which is videos. This directory has the least size, while the MKV file has the largest size. Yeah. Let's clear the terminal. Go to the next command, which is ls switch n. This will show you the user ID and the group ID identities, but it will show you numbers. Like for this, you see in our case here, our user and the group, it has shown the names, like this one is root, this one is just root. So when you come here, the user ID and the group ID is just 00 for the root. And the last command we have for today is ls switch I. This shows you the index. It shows you the index number that is assigned to the file and directories upon creation, which is unique to each and every file that you is given. So that's it. So I would like to conclude with our last command, which is not in the ls. So it's just something fun. I just found it recently. For it's the first of all, you have to install it. That's apt install symmetrix. Mine's already installed, so when you just run symmetrix, yeah, this shows up. Like it's famous, like for the, it shows the Matrix. For those who've watched Matrix movies, this is something you can just, it's something cool. You can just show it to your friends. They may think you are some pro, you're an pro hacker or something like that. For you to stop it, just Control C. can just, yeah, that's it. For you can even use it for given far, you can change on how you can use it, symmetrics, switch R, that shows it outputs. That put has changed, the previous one was green, now it shows like the rainbow, that's for the switch R. So thank you. Control C, see you next time. Peace. Exit.